You all heard of salt and pepper, bread and butter, Tom and Jerry. These are examples of how a combination of two things can make something work beautifully. In my career, I discovered two very important things, which was something that made everything I did really extraordinary in my opinion and from whatever I could see. And the ingredient for this was the powerful medium of creativity and the visual medium. To me, creativity is so powerful that it has such a strong influence on everything that we do. And I think creativity, honestly, can turn a grain of sand into a universe. It's up to the person who is working on it to make sure how big and how large the scale of that is. And not only that, creativity has the power to generate a billion-dollar idea with almost nothing. I want to share with you the power of visual elements as much. Did you know that the visual element or visuals are transmitted to the brain and transferred at the fastest rate? It is transferred at 60,000 times faster than what you would probably see anything to do with text or sound. And 90% of everything that we see today is stored in the brain as visual contexts, and that's what it occupies as a space. I would like to tell you, as a co-founder of Graphic India, I have had the opportunity to work with some of the most creative and talented minds. And these talented people have been able to really change the dynamics, and I'll show you some of that work later on, and you kind of appreciate that. Change the dynamics in terms of way of looking at things and see how they can take this whole medium of creativity and the visual element and use it extremely well. And comic book artists, who are what we have done a lot as an incubation of ideas, because that makes the perfect incubation of taking an idea and seeing how it's going to work. Comic book artists have this amazing imagination that lets you travel through the universe, through awe and adventure, and then all of a sudden they destroy the universe, and then in the same breath, they recreate another whole new universe. All this in less than 20 to 22 pages. That's the power of a comic book artist. And not only that, he keeps you immersed in that content. And I'm sure a lot of us are influenced with comic books and the visualization as we grew up. And even today, keeping entertainment involved is a very, very important thing. I want to tell you that everything doesn't work so easily like every other field. A lot of talent comes with a lot of hard work. And I would like to mention sometimes, you know, the amount of work that one needs to put in could be as much as 99% of input in terms of information and resources before you can take out 1%, which is probably relevant and useful. I want us to know that comic book ideas are discussed in any kind of a brainstorming. We have ideas, people come up with ideas, come up with stories. And we have an open forum, there are no rules. Everybody is free to talk and learn and kind of see how this thing evolves. A lot of us don't want to necessarily listen what is right or what is crazy. Everything is open. But the magic is, out of all this discussion, an idea emerges. And that is the true magic. And how it happens is something that is interesting unless you are in it. I'm sure it happens in other ideas also. If you have a problem and the minute you're able to solve it, you know, you feel very challenged and you feel very happy about it. I want to take it further and I want to share with you in terms of these people who are creative artists, and I'm going to show you some work that you'll see shortly, are not just artists who can visually translate or tell a story that is interesting. They have the power literally almost as big as the universe. They create environments, they create characters, they create armory, they create jewelry, they create style. I mean, it's like, it's amazing where all this thing comes from. So it's interesting to know how creativity can be translated from just an idea and a thought into a visual medium that can be as captivating and as powerful. And while I'm going to show you some of that work, but before that, I would like to take you around and quickly show you the evolution of visual storytelling, right? So it all started as primitive as cave paintings, right? If you really look at it, there is a story here. Maybe if somebody hasn't seen kind of animals or horses, it's easy to tell somebody this is what is the reference point. It started fundamentals, right? And so this is there. I mean, in the picture that you're able to see certain animals on one side, and you see some animals and a human being, maybe a stick. It was enough to communicate that there was something happening with the skill sets of whoever had it, right? In this particular thing, you know there is a person who has a bow and an arrow, and the other side you have some wild animals and people are trying to shoot away, maybe they'll lions. So there is a story. So when somebody sees this visual and somebody meets them, there is a transition and there is a story that is evolving. Now we come to India, we come to US and early comics. So if you really look at comic books earlier on, which is still a huge industry, and what is beautiful about comic books is that incubate ideas which then translate into movies, games, animations, and so on and so forth. We all know Superman and Batman, and these are the early days of how dresses were made or sketches were made. And it was very simple. The story kind of led the content much more in terms of visual rather than the visuals itself. You come to India, and we're all very familiar with the Indian mythological stories, you know, and we all have our superheroes in our own mythology. It's how drama is shown, whether there is violence or anger or, you know, some kind of a scale in terms of a drawing, that's what you see. And this is us now, today, okay? And the whole style, the way of looking at things has dynamically changed. And this has changed because coming back to this use of creativity and the visual medium, how do you translate an idea, a creative thought, and how do you make it dynamically interesting and relevant? And there is a tremendous amount of talent. Like I said earlier, it's a lot of input, a lot of exposure, global and local, and interaction that generates ideas, generates thoughts that are both ideas and visual execution. So this is called 18 days. This is Mahabharata. So you saw a certain element earlier on, you know, maybe a decade or two decades ago in terms of what was style, what was drama. Now, these are ideas that translate into all formats, be it live action or whether it's animation or gaming. So if you really look at it, and I will dwell on it a little bit, you look at the detailing, you look at every character, you look at every armor, every jewelry, every kind of form, composition, and lighting. There's a lot of thought that's going into it. And this is emerging amazingly fast. A comic book artist creates a whole universe in 20 to 22 pages or 24 pages. And he does four or five panels in a page in maybe a day, right? And that's how fast he's able to kind of go through his ideas. This is creation. This is Brahma, this is universe, right? You know, in terms of scale, in terms of, you know, how do you get... And now this is war, this is the real war, the 18 days. And then you look at it, you have Beam, you have the other characters, and you have a whole horizon line. This interpretation, of course, we have some kind of an alien kind of a spacecraft also moving, because it's a timeline where you, the artist's interpretation has taken you into something. Same here. I'm just showing some of these things quickly so that you kind of get an idea in terms of how it is treated and how the mood and the feeling comes through much more clearly. And it's a great medium because it works as a storyboard to convert it into movies. Even here, I mean, at the end of the day, they have a trumpet to call the war off, and then everybody can mend, you know? So, just goes to show to me and to everybody else in the youth, and then we are interacting with a lot of them, and globally, ideas that are not local to India anymore, ideas that have a global feel and appeal, right? Okay, so this is other ideas as an execution. This is another property called Devi, and she's a goddess, and she has her own superpowers. And this is Indian art. Even though this is stylized, different styles are emerging, but you know, it conveys the anger of Kali or the dynamism of a Shiva. And that, this is, how does an artist imagine a girl walking down a street and she is actually, you know, tormented with the thought maybe something is happening around her, right? So here is what he has tried to take an element and then take it into a situation like a nightmare. She's getting really panicky. Anyway, so what I would like to say at this moment in time is that a lot of us all have the creative ability in many things that we do, but a lot of us, I feel, are not spending enough time towards trying to make something interesting. Can we try to take something that is ordinary and actually look at it and change it and make it into something extraordinary, right? So I really feel that if everybody tries to make life simple, and if you can actually take every day and use all the knowledge, all your dreams, and all your imagination, and creatively change your own world and change the world around you. Thank you.